Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, The Life of Charm. Again, my name is Sharday. I know it has been so long, and I'm sorry that it's taking so long, but it's just been like so much stuff going on. So I'm gonna kind of do like a brief intro kind of announcement thing too about my business, Charming Eats. Then I'm gonna pray, then I'm gonna start eating, but I wanna do that part first so I can cut it out. First, let's go ahead and get a thumbnail. Okay, that should work. I'll edit that out. Okay, anyway, don't forget to go ahead and like, share, subscribe to my channel, and comment down below. I can't wait to get in the comments and get to know more of my followers and subscribers. Actually, my subscribers. And just hang out with you guys as you get to know me. And of course, I'll get to know some of you because you guys are literally starting from the bottom with your girl. So tonight, we're actually going to be eating Saks Wing Shack, and that's here in Chattanooga, Tennessee on Brainerd Road. I'm not sure of the address, but it's really good. You can find their menu and stuff like that online. I think it's on Facebook, but I'm not sure. But their catfish is really, really good, and I also got their wings, hot lemon pepper, mostly flats, because y'all know I just don't do flats are really where it's at, okay? And I got some celery and some ranch, and I got a little Gatorade. I'm still trying to rehydrate myself. I'll tell y'all about this story a little later on. Candles give me a little vibe, and then my napkins, and of course, but I'm about to get down. But first, I want to give a special last call, because by the time I post this, it'll maybe be later this evening and in the morning, and it's Monday, February the 18th. Last call to buy your raffle tickets for the Charming Eats experience. And this is going to be an evening where you win a dinner for two. Doesn't have to be a couple, just a dinner for two. You and your friends can hang out, just depends on whatever you wanna do. Dinner for two, and that you'll have a full course meal starting with an amazing appetizer, and your choice between chicken or salmon for your entree. Also, my great glazed strawberry cake. It's amazing, and of course champagne would be provided. Also, just a really fun, nice experience and a chance for you to get to know me, and we'll talk about more details about that later on. But anyway, buy your raffle tickets. Those are $3. You can cash app me at $CharmingEats to get your tickets, and I will be doing the live drawing tomorrow on Facebook and Instagram tomorrow evening at, I believe I said, 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, so that'll be 8 p.m. Central, because I know I had some people actually who purchased out of town. I really do not mind traveling. If you guys support and you win, you know, I got to meet my offer. So it's not been too far. I'm telling y'all, if it's more than 2 hours, I'm not driving. Okay? Anywho, really look forward to this. This is just something fun I wanted to do. And of course, you can always book me for any of your private chef needs or personal in-home cooking. I also do healthy, affordable meal prep options, as well as small catering at the moment. Anyway, guys, I'm getting hungry. I'm ready to eat. So I'm gonna actually edit that little clip out and post that so you guys can see that. Also, hopefully that gets us some more views and subscribers to the channel. This is the life of charm, baby. Okay, yeah, I'm about to start eating. I'm about to pray, and then I'm gonna just tell y'all about everything that's been going on. It's been a crazy past 2 weeks, okay? Dear God, thank you for this day that you've given me. Thank you for this food that you have provided me with. God, let it be for the nourishment of my body, and bless the hands that prepared it. And it's in your son Jesus' name that I do pray. Amen. Amen. Okay, yeah, so I'm about to eat. Okay, yeah, so y'all, it's been a long time. First of all, the Patriots won the Super Bowl. I haven't done a mukbang since then. The Super Bowl party was actually pretty lit. It was like a pre-birthday turn up. It was amazing, like super fun. I actually fell asleep, but that's neither here nor there. Then my birthday just passed, guys. If you wanna cash up your girl a little birthday present, that's cool too. But my birthday was February the 6th, which was a week and a half ago. I had a really great time. Day off from work, pampered myself, went to dinner, salsa dancing. That was different. It was fun. I really enjoyed my birthday. I'm trying to eat and still fill y'all in. So yeah, that was my birthday. And then, oh yeah, I don't leave no meat on the bone. So if y'all don't, y'all got a problem with it, I don't know what to tell you. But it's fine though. Okay. I went to Nashville Friday night. I hung out with my brother, my cousin, my friends. I got some friends that live down in Murfreesboro in Nashville. We all hung out, had dinner. It was a good time. And Saturday, hung out some more, came back in town, and it was a really good weekend. I had to go home last week. I had a death in the family. My uncle, Charles, he passed away. I call him Tata. He passed away last Tuesday. So I went home Wednesday because I also went home to check on my mom. And I had been there from, well, I went to Nashville Wednesday night, but I had been there and I just got back last night. So it's been a lot going on. I've been moving and grooving. But I have not stopped thinking about my channel. I have not stopped thinking about work and just everything that I'm kind of involved in. I like to stay busy. If you guys can hear Brody, I'm so sorry. He's doing the most. I don't know what I'm going to do. I think it'll be easier once it warms up because I have a screened-in porch and a backyard. He's just going to sit here and cry because he wants to be in somebody's face. So, I do apologize if you hear him. This is my celery, guys. This is really not a healthy meal, but sometimes I like what I like, okay? And this celery makes me feel better about it. Okay, and then, y'all. So, being at home and just everything that's kind of been going on. Some things I'll keep to myself, guys. Maybe I'll tell you at another time, but right now I'll keep to myself. It's just been like super stressful. And I don't think I was eating my normal. It was very frustrating and exhausting and a whole bunch of other emotions. It was also funny and loving. When I go home, a lot of times I get strength. But anywho, hold on, Gatorade break. I can't remember which one this is. Like Glacier? No. Glacier is that light blue one. This is the dark purple one. It's good. Okay. Anyway, so yesterday, I get up and I went to the hospital and I sat with my mom for most of the day. Like literally, got up at like 7:30 yesterday morning, Sunday morning. And y'all, this catfish is so good. Ooh. Sunday morning, like 7:30 to 2 o'clock, I was at the hospital. After I left the hospital, so me and my brother like trying to decide what we're going to eat. So we're doing that. And we're also on our way to go see my uncle, because he recently had a procedure, and then I haven't seen him in a long time. Me and my auntie love him so much. We go to see him. And it's like on the other side of town, so it's like an hour or so that went by now. And we both hungry. So we were going to go to some, we were actually going to go to Prebay, which is Yo Gotti's mama's soul food restaurant or whatever. They have like soul food on Sundays or something. We were gonna go there, but parking lot was completely packed. I was trying to get on the road. It was too much. Then he wanted to go to someplace called Southern Hands. It's a buffet. I am not big on buffets. It's not for me. But we're pulling up. It's an ambulance in the front. I said, if that's any testament to how the food is, we not going there. I got to watch my blood pressure and anything else. We not going there. So we drive all the way back down Winchester. And we end up going to Red Lobster. Cool. I ain't never too good for Red Lobster, child. So we go to Red Lobster. We chilling. I'm gonna tell you literally how the evening went. Afternoon. I literally drank 2 raspberry lemonades. I guess I was thirsty because my brother said, he said, you thirsty, ain't it? So I drank those, had the salad. Y'all know they always get a little pre-salad. It always be good. I kind of peeked over it. I think I was just hungry. I was ready for the food, but I was starting to feel kind of weird. So Devin went to the restroom. The food comes back. I'm sitting there and I done kind of got hot really quick. So I was like, I don't know what's going on, but let me go to the restroom, wash my hands, freshen up, come back and eat. I get to the restroom and I was like, okay, get it together, sis. You're struggling. Get back to the table. So I get back to the table and as soon as I sit down, I'm like, ugh, something is wrong. I'm gonna fall out. Now, for any of you who watch my channel and you know me, I have fallen out in public places quite a few times in my life. It's always the same reason, because I have not eaten or I've overheated and I will fall out very easily. I've done it at church. I've done it at work. Actually, 2 jobs. I've done it at home. I've done it in restaurants. And here I am at another restaurant, Red Lobster's. I was like, Devin, I gotta go. Have her pack up my food. It's going by really fast. Have her pack up my food. I pull my card out. I throw it on the counter. And I'm walking out. And I'm almost dizzy at this point. And Devin, this is my brother Devin, guys. That's who Devin is. I'm gonna bring him on my channel at one point. He goes, get your purse. Here, get your stuff. And I was like, dude, I cannot carry. I'm just going to go to the car and lay down because I'm hot. I think I need to lay down. And he was like, okay, cool. Now, we were sitting at the bar. So, the bar and the door are maybe 8 to 10 steps from each other. I think I got to step 6. And then I got up. Like, that's the order of events. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then I got up. And then when I got up, the first thing I was thinking was, man, my knees hurt. But I'm not realizing that I literally just fainted in this restaurant. My brother is trying to pick me up off the floor. And I think a lot of people thought I tripped, like fell face forward, but no, I fainted. And I'm like trying to get up. It was just horrible. And I was like, I'm going to be okay, Devin. I just need to get to the car. Like, it was just so much. And he was just like, girl, like, oh my God. He was freaking out. Then when we get in the car, he was like, girl, you crazy. He pretty much laughed at me. But what's crazy is he's done it and my dad has done it. Like, I don't know what it is, because every time I go to the doctor, like right after it happens, there's nothing wrong. I've had tests done. I don't know what else to even look for at this point, but my sugar will drop like in a second and I will be on the floor. So it's for that reason that I always try to have crackers, cookies, and something that on me in any time, just in case. But that's story time for today. What's been going on in y'all life? Drop down in the comments. As my boy or girl, fuck it, I need to what's that. And stir it up. Y'all, I love YouTube. I love YouTube. Like, if YouTube, which you can pull your app up on the TV, but I don't like for it to look kind of like a search engine. I want it to look more like television. But It'd be like the channel Funky Dineva come on, or the channel The Breakfast Club come on. Not me go to search for their page, and I don't want it to look like that. But anyway, y'all, this food is really good. Again, Saks Wing Shack. I just put this in ranch. I don't even like it, but I'm gonna see what it tastes like. The buttermilk is too overpowering. I can't taste the fish, so no. But it's on Brainerd Road here in Chattanooga. And again, I plan to continue to like shout out different restaurants in the city that are local. Oh, your girl got the hot noodles in. Two times spicy. So I'm gonna do that challenge Wednesday. Again, my plan is to record three times a week. I think it's gonna be Monday or Tuesday, Wednesday, and then Thursday or Friday. I know that was strange. I just plan to get at least three videos done a week. And so I'll start there. I definitely gotta do a seafood boil soon. I've been tripping big time. Slowing down. But I can't wait to do the king crab and them big lobster tails. Woo! I'm gonna turn that up. I think I'm gonna get that Alaskan snow crab too. Test that out. That thing be looking good. With that B-Love sauce. Yeah, this is a lot of food. I'm not gonna eat all this. Let me see how long we've been on. Not that long, about 15 minutes. 16, I don't know. Let me see. What else going on? My birthday month is almost coming to an end. I can definitely say I really enjoyed my birthday. I'm excited about this next year. It's 2019, and I'm like super excited business wise. I'm super excited. Just even for personal growth and change. Oh, I'm excited to see Kamala Harris and Cory Booker and see kind of how their, I want to see their strategy. I want to see their agenda and their talking points and how well they can convey that message. I think that's going to be, it's going to be really good. I hope we don't do the same thing we did the last time and say y'all don't like who was picked and then don't vote, or Trump will be president again. And it'll be y'all fault again. You know? But who are me? What else been going on? Y'all, that Jussie Smollett stuff? I'm so confused. I'm so lost. Don't know what's the truth or what to believe. So it's almost like just like whatever, because you don't know the truth, you know? I definitely don't believe him until y'all can show me evidence. But I feel like that about any situation, because people lie so much. I want you, which is I guess a bad thing. That's the point. They're trying to prove that they have to prove that they're a victim. But at the same time, when so many people are accused and they're not guilty, but you pretty much say they're guilty because you accuse them. You know, it's I don't know. I just feel like it needs to be fair and equal for everybody. And people need to keep their hands, feet, and all other objects to themselves. Did y'all not learn that in elementary school? Gosh. But anywho. Yeah. I don't know. That's a really strange case. I would hope nobody would make up something like that. And then I would hope that the Chicago police wouldn't be, I mean, like, why would they lie? You know what I mean? I don't know. I just don't know what's truth right now. This is too much. This is way too much. It is ironic, though, that they brought in two people who were connected to him and said that they were the attackers. But then they've been released, so they weren't the attackers. So did you pick them up so that you can make him look guilty? You know, I don't know. Something about this whole thing is just not making sense. But anyway, I'm trying to think. What new have I watched on Netflix? Okay, I did watch the story about Sam Cooke. I watched that the other night with my brother. It was actually pretty interesting. I don't think I finished it, actually. No, I did finish it. Yeah. I also watched the Trigger Mike series. I don't know what it's called. I don't know if it's Trick or something. I don't know. I watched that. Oh, I gotta watch Grey's Anatomy from last week. Definitely need to do that. I did watch Housewives. Interesting. And I don't know. I've been watching a lot of documentaries on YouTube. Ooh, I hope it don't sound like I'm just smacking. I'm really not. I do prefer whole wings over like the party wings. That was perfect. Because first of all, I don't know, I just don't understand how chicken be little sometimes and big sometimes. We don't know what we eat. I guess that's why everybody's saying we need to be vegan, but I like meat. Yeah, I be tripping myself out. Oh yeah, the hot lemon pepper. I don't know if I told y'all that or not, but these are hot lemon pepper. I definitely need to invest more in my channel and start spending more time with it, posting more videos. I think the more I post, the more subscribers I'll get. I also haven't shared any of my videos yet. And it's not because I don't think people will subscribe. It's just because it's like I want my channel to look a certain way before I be like inviting people. But I mean, I guess it's live now, so it's like you are still inviting people. I don't know. I want it to be right. And on top of me wanting to be right, I want everything to look good, and I want to do like that one hit video that go viral. But I got to keep doing it in order to find that one. So the more I do it, the better I get. It's definitely not as easy as you would think. And if it is that easy, I don't think you're trying to apply yourself and change, you know? You want to do something different. I mean, it's a lot of channels. Everybody gonna like something different. You never know. But you just want to set yourself apart. And I have a lot of people that I'll be looking to for inspiration. But I definitely want to have my own flair on my channel, you know? Oh. Valentine's Day was so slow, y'all. Oh my God, I can't believe I just smacked like that. Oh my God, that was bad. But yeah, I bought me and my mama a Build-A-Bear. Child. It was a cool Valentine's Day. I got to see her and spend it with her, so she had been on my mind all week. I mean, even the whole past week, so. And again, like I said, I went home for homegoing service of my uncle. So I got a chance to see my dad and his siblings, my cousins. of course, you know, you're coming together for a sad time, but a lot of memories, definitely seeing everybody together in one place. But definitely gonna miss my uncle, like, seriously. My uncle Tim actually texted me. He was just like, holiday is gonna be a little quieter. What's crazy is, we went over my auntie's house after the service and the repast and all of that, and the house was still loud. So I'm sure we gonna have it okay in the loud apartment, because we just be talking and laughing. But definitely this one hit really hard. So y'all keep my family in your prayers, man. Pray for my daddy. Pray for my daddy. He was just so broken down, Lord. That told me up, I'm trying to tell you. So, but seriously, it was good to see everybody. And really, like, me and my brother, we've always been like this, but I think more now too. We like stuck like glue, like knee high and tree high, like A1 since day one. You know what I'm saying? That's the homie. And I'm like super proud of him and happy for him. And he pushed me, he loves on me and encourages me. So I'm trying to give him a YouTube channel. He a musician. He don't do nothing but sit on YouTube all day and watch music videos. And it's just like, bro, get on your drums and do this yourself. How about that? So maybe I'm gonna give him a channel. I'm gonna bring him on my video one time. I might go to Nashville and do a Wingstop video, because we don't have a Wingstop in Chattanooga. Either Wingstop or we'll do a seafood video. But my brother, a pretty boy, he was not trying to get with them crab legs, man. That man said, I'm gonna get the fish. Man, if you don't get no crab legs. Anywho, I think I've eaten enough. We're on like 25, 26 minutes. So thank y'all for tuning back in. Again, don't forget about the raffle. I'm gonna post about that tonight. And I might just post this video in honor of my uncle. And just to be my first time sharing the video and getting people to just come and see it. Again, like, share, subscribe to my channel, The Life of Charm. My name is Sharday. And again, I cannot wait to charm you. Bye.